Hello all, myself Janil Popat. Let us begin a new chapter, Particle Size Analysis. So, we are analyzing particle sizes in this chapter. In this image, you can see that different bubbles are having different diameters, different sizes. Let us discuss this chapter with starting off coarse and fine-grained soils. Let us differentiate coarse-grained and fine-grained soils. So, if your 50% of soil or more than 50% of soil is having diameter more than 75 micron, then the soil will be coarse grained soils. The grains are coarse because more than 50% of grains are having size 75 micron. Same, if the 75 micron size lesser than same way, if more than 50% of the bubbles, or we can say particles, are less than in size 75 microns, then it is a fine grained soil. If the soil is cohesion less, then it will be a coarse grained soil. If it is a cohesive soil, then it is a fine grained soil. Cohesion means the attraction between the particles which are of same material. So, if the soil is having some cohesion, it will be a fine-grained soil. Now, if we talk about examples of coarse-grained soils, it will be a gravel and sand. So, you see gravels on the river side are having cohesion-less bonding. Same way, if you see cohesive soil like silt and clay, they are fine-grained soils. Same way, coarse-grained soils are non-plastic soils, where fine grained soils are plastic soils. Plasticity means the moldability, we can say. For right now, we can say moldability is plasticity. So, if the soil is having some plasticity property or moldability property, then it will be a fine grained soil. Otherwise, it will be a coarse grained soil. Amount of water absorbed will be less in coarse grained soil. So, it is but obvious if it is a cohesion less soil, then it will absorb less amount of water and it will be a coarse grained soil. Where if it is absorbing more water, then it will be a fine grained soil because cohesion will require more amount of water. Electrochemical forces between particles are weak in coarse grained soils. So, in coarse grained soils, electrochemical means it is including electrons and protons, etc. These forces are weak in coarse-grained soils. That is why it is a cohesion-less soil. Where in fine-grained soils, the electrochemical bondings and forces between particles are strong. So, this is how we can differentiate coarse-grained and fine-grained soils. Moving forward to particle size distribution. So, now particle size distribution. How to distribute them in the different sizes? For that, there are two basic ideas or tests. First, dry, and second one is wet. So, we can say dry analysis and wet analysis. Now, dry means sieve analysis, where wet means sedimentation analysis. When we are talking about dry analysis, you will need CGS, or you are having CGS, coarse grained soils, right? In coarse grained soils, particle size will be greater than 75 microns, as we have discussed before this slide. In wet analysis, the soil should be particle size having less than 75 microns, and particle size here should be more than 50% of particles should be of these sizes. That is how we can differentiate CGS and FGS. It is very obvious. Now, for dry sieve analysis, we can do coarse size analysis and fine size analysis. For coarse size analysis, you need 4.75 to 80 mm size of soil, where fine size analysis, you need to have 0.075 to 4.75 mm size of soil, as well as sieves are of should be this sizes. In wet analysis, if we talk, you should use hydrometer method or pipette method. These both are similar methods, both are different, but both are almost similar method. Through that, you can calculate or distribute the sizes of wet analysis, or we can say fine-grained soils. So this is basic flowchart of this chapter. Now, if we move further in dry analysis as sieve analysis. So, objective of sieve analysis is to determine grain size distribution of soil. So, basically, grain size distribution. So, grain sizes should be acknowledged here. Now, equipment required for that is sieves of all sizes from 4.75 mm to 100 mm. So, IS sieve is basically a sieve of Indian standard. So, Indian standard suggests some sizes, specific sizes of sieves. So, you need 4.75 to 100 mm different sizes of sieves. And again, second range for fine sieve, fine size analysis, 4.75 mm to 75 micron size sieves. You need weigh balance with accuracy of 0.01 grams. So, you need weigh balance. So, the sieves should be racked like this. They are stacked like this. One sieve, second sieve, third sieve, they fit into each other. And the larger meshes from the larger particles will be here. Sieves will vary with from larger meshes to smaller or finer meshes, and particles will be like this only. And in the last, pan should be kept, which will be intransparent or which will not pass any type of soil, that is receiver only. So moving forward to reference. Reference is given by IS 2720. Now it is part 4, right? So this IS code suggests this procedure. Now let us go to procedure. First step, very first step you will do for sieve analysis is take 1000 gram of soil sample from disturbed representative sample. Now disturbed sample and undisturbed sample, very basic idea, let me give that. Disturbed sample is what? When you disturb the soil structure, like you dig and remove the soil, that is a disturbed sample. But undisturbed sample is what? Without disturbing any soil structure, you can cut the core of that, and that will give you undisturbed soil sample. So we will take normal digged or disturbed sample here for sieve analysis, but the base would be 1000 gram of soil sample. Second step, that is conduct sieve analysis using a set of standard sieves as given in the data sheet. So, data sheet will provide you the sizes of sieves. The sieving may be done either by hand or by mechanical sieve shaker for 10 minutes. So, these are the racking or stacking of the sieve, right? You can see this in the figure. Now, you will do what? You will shake all the sieves by hand or mechanical sieve shaker. So, in generally, in lab, mechanical sieve shakers are there. And they do what? They shake them in a harmonical or in a systematic manner. After 10 minutes, all the soil will be distributed in the different sieves. So, if the 1000 gram sieve, if the 1000 gram of soil is put on the top of this stack, the soil will be distributed in all the different IS sieves. Right, after 10 minutes. So, now, fourth step will be weigh the material retained on the sieve. So, on each sieve, there will be some material and you have to weigh that material. After weighing that material, you will get to know what are the sizes of the sieves. So, let us move to next step. The percentage retained on each sieve is calculated on the basis of total weight of the soil sample. Now, you know total weight of the soil sample was 1000 grams. Now, if 10% of that is retained on the second sieve, then you will get to know 10% of soil is like this. Same way, If we go further, you will get to know it clearly. Next step is, from these results, the percentage passing through each of the sieves is calculated. As we have talked, percentage passing from each sieve should be calculated. If the 1000 gram is on the top of the sieve, and in the second sieve, if 500 grams is there, 50% is passed and 50% is retained on the second stick or second ISU. So you will get to know what are the sizes or distribution of soil. Draw the grain size curve. So you need to draw a curve for the soil in the semi-logarithmic graph provided. So you need to draw a graph too. We will get to know how to draw that. Let us understand this right now. After this, you will fill an observation table. In this observation table, these are the different column heads are given: serial number, ISCU, mass retained in grams, mass retained in percentage, cumulative retained and cumulative percentage passing. So these are the column heads. Now, different sizes of sieves as in the data sheet is given: 20 mm, 10 mm, 4.75, 2 mm, 1 mm, 600 micron, 425 micron, 300 micron, 150 micron, 75 micron, and at last receiver or the pan is kept. Now let us go into depth of observation table. Here, if the mass is retained 1 gram, you will put 1 gram here. If it is 100 grams, you will write 100 grams here. Now, distributing all the, weighing all the sieves and retaining soil of that sieve, you will write here some mass. Total mass of this all sieves will make 1000 grams, right? Because you have taken 1000 grams initially. So, you will get distribution of the soil. After that, you will fill the second column, which is percentage mass retained. So, if it is 100 grams and total was 1000 grams, it is a 10% of that. So, you write down 10% here. Cumulative retained. So, in the second column, if you are putting, in the second row, if you are putting the value of cumulative retained. So, 10 mm sieve will retain two data. First, will retain two soils, which is retaining on 20 mm and passing from 20 mm both. So you will write cumulative figures here and you will write percentage cumulative figures in this column. So this is how you will prepare observation table of that. From observation table, you will prepare a graph which is called particle size distribution curve. Here the S shaped curve is seen here. The y-axis here is percentage passing and x-axis is showing particle diameter in mm. So this is a semi-logarithmic graph. So you are seeing the graph like this. In this, the values are put and the graph in this S shape can be obtained. Here, 3 points are very much important: D10, D30 and D60. Here D10 is here. D30 is here somewhere and D60 is here. What is D10? So D10 is particle size such that 10% of them are finer. So D10 is a point where it is defined as particle size such that 10% of them are finer than that. So D60 will be same way, particle size such that after that 60% of them are finer than that size. Right, and same way D30 works. So this is the procedure for testing sieve analysis. That is how you will get to prepare a particle size distribution curve or grading curve. So that's it for this lecture. We will understand further technicalities in next video. Thank you.